Mr. Avalon.
Because like he's what? Sexy.
Talking about penises.
Fuck me hard as hell.
I'll just leave my shirt.
These affluent, fucked up kids gravitate towards Mickey's music because Mickey is talking about, you know, real everyday life experiences.
Mickey is the Charles Bukowski of rap. So I've known him since we grew up, and he's not bullshitting. He's not a faker.
I've got angles that don't tangle, masterminds with heart. Fuck it, I'll even run a bum for his shopping cart.
You hear shit like that and you can relate to it because you know idiots that are running around wasted and doing whatnot, right?
That's what we do.
A lot of his lyrics come from straight experiences. He talks about it. He's lurking in the garden with snakes and gutter rats. Like, you can laugh at that. That was true.
Mickey, how much stuff, if you listen to it, it gives you a feeling, like a feeling of being on drugs or a feeling of being tense. Or you can hear it.
It's for real with him. He's from Hollywood. He used to tag. He is what he is. He's not faking it. He's not trying to fucking pull some scene. That's what you get on the streets of Hollywood right there. It ain't the Walk of Fame. Okay, people come off the bus at the Man's Theater and see the names and shit, but you walk around a block there and shit's going down.
I like a girl with caked up makeup in the sunshine, smoking cigarettes to pass the time. Who wakes up to a bottle of wine on the nightstand, bison scratches the blinds, but I ain't found one quite right yet. So I step with Pat to the park or supermarket. Her apartment, Vespri, messy, and Lisa don't mind when I call her Leslie. She got to dress with class. Jean Paul Gaultier and an Air Max bag with 4-inch tits made the ostrich. Shopping at the stitcher, it's a lip spread gossip. Won't say something when she offends. She come over to my place in the old man's Benz and go dancing for angels of all colors. And she doesn't take them off from a tearing up the cover.
Come on, get it before I change my mind.
Come on.
Come on, kid, don't waste my time. So rich, so pretty.
The best piece of ass in the whole damn city.
So rich, so pretty.
I like a girl who eats and brings it up. A sassy little fussy with bulimia. Her best friend's a plastic surgeon, and when the beam is in the shop, she mayonnaise and petties on Sundays and Wednesdays. Money for mommy, lovely and Versace. Cassie's breezes on their bonnies, and I love to watch her go through 50 G's calmly. She gets snotty with her Pilates body and thinks it's really funny when her nose goes bloody, cause the blow's so yummy and it keeps her tummy empty and makes her act more friendly. Dance the night away, and she won't say nothing when she makes you menstruate.
Come on, get it before I change my mind. Come on, kid, don't waste my time. So rich, so pretty.
The best piece of ass in the whole damn city.
Come on, get it before I change my mind. Come on, kid, don't waste my time. So rich, so pretty.
The best piece of ass in the whole damn city. I've had you come before, Mickey. Go get my purse, Mickey. Lock the door, Mickey. You're just a midnight snack. Shh. Don't talk back.
Mickey. He has a sick tattoo that says thank you. And
it's like right here. It says thank you.
I always picture like a girl in front of him, you know, as soon as she's done giving Mickey head, like she looks up at him and it just says thank you.
Thank you for sucking my dick.
Shit is gonna go down.
If you don't know, let me show you how to work it out. Work it, little mama. I know you wanna do the Jane Fonda.
I know you wanna do the Jane Fonda. Jane Fonda is a dance, making a girl do a lot of different sexual positions, like Jane Fonda's workout while you're fucking laying the pipe.
Are you doing the Jane Fonda?
I'm going to.
Sweet.
She's good. She's good at it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get your booty on the dance floor. Work it out. Come on, pretty mama. Let me see you do the Jane Fonda.
Awesome. I had a princess, queen of incest. She was in red, but Jean had big breasts and big eyes and a big ass to match. Jean wasn't fat, she was easy to catch. Then came Molly, a hood from Hollywood High. So fly, she was transatlantic. She was a manic depressive. which was impressive, very impressive. I had to test it, tasted like chicken and was lemon scented. She took me home to her mama. I taught them both how to Jane Fonda. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get your booty on the dance floor. Work it out, shake it little mama. Let me see you do the Jane Fonda. 5, 6, 7 now. If you don't know, let me show you how to work it out. Work it little mama, I know you wanna do the Jane Fonda. I had a doll named Dana from Santa Ana. She was a waitress at the Copacabana. She was slamming and her ass was jamming, like Janet Jackson in the Rhythm Nation. Her brother Jason had a girl named Grace, and you could see her ass from outer space. So I landed on a planet, and planted a Mickey F flag in it, damn it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get your booty on the dance floor. Work it out, shake it little mama. Let me see you do the Jane Fonda. 5, 6, 7 now. If you don't know, let me show you how to work it out. Work it little mama, I know you wanna do the Jane Fonda. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get your booty on the dance floor. Work it out, shake it little mama. Let me see you do the Jane Fonda.
The coolest things was the scalp ticket. The first known scalp ticket that was kept. Mickey Avalon tickets, Mickey Avalon tickets. I said, what? He said, Mickey Avalon tickets, $35. I went, I'll take one, dude.
This right here, first scalp ticket for $35 to Mickey Avalon.
$14 face value, bought it for $35. His inflation rate's going up.
All I ever wanted to do was put out a record. And I've been fortunate enough that I got to put one out that I'm very, very proud of. And I'm looking forward to putting out more.
Oh, we like him to sell fucking 10 million records.
I want to see him like buy 5 houses and fucking buy me a Ferrari.
I want to see an arena full of people singing Mr. Right.
Yes, yeah, I always didn't believe that this could really happen. I always had to pound in his head. I'm like, you could really do this. You could really blow up. And he was always like, come, you know, he's like, that's cool, but you know.
And there was times when he was like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. He was delivering pizzas in Santa Monica. Everyone knew him as Mickey Avalon. His people, his CDs are getting out there. People know he's doing shows. But you know, in reality, he's coming home and going to deliver pizzas in Santa Monica to support himself. And so there was times there when, you know, happy times in that, but also times where he was just feeling, what am I fucking doing here?
He just had enough people around him supporting him that it's getting to the point where becoming very real, and he's seeing the money coming in. He could support for his daughter, and that's a beautiful thing, you know. And as long as he could support his daughter and pay his child support and be eating, have a roof over his head, he's a happy guy. He doesn't need a lot, you know, but I think he could have the world. I think he could have fucking, I see him on the cover of Rolling Stone like this.
Rock and roll is what it is. It's, I mean, I've seen girls faint to Mickey Avalon, freak out to Dirt Nasty, freak out to Andre Legacy. I mean, that's the buzz you see from your homie that you know and hang out with. To see that shit affect girls like that, amazing. Fucking amazing.
Hey, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine, buddy. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey.
Oh, there it is.
Mickey, let's go.
Do it.
Do it now. Mickey! We're ready for you.
We are going to have open sexual intercourse on every street corner of America.
It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder that God must be one sick motherfucker. So I bust a nut in the sky, spend another day waiting to die.